Ever seen those epic speed ramps or that buttery smooth slow motion and wondered, how do they do that? What if I told you that all of those pro level time effects are just a few clicks away inside Adobe Premiere Pro? Well, you're in the right place. In the next few minutes, I'm going to show you everything you need to know to control speed, create true cinematic slow motion, reverse time, and build those awesome speed ramps that will take your videos to the next level. Let's get started. All right, we're inside Premiere Pro. Let's start with the absolute foundation of time manipulation, the speed or duration tool. It's powerful and super easy to use. To access it, just right-click on any clip in your timeline and select speed duration. This little box is our control center. You'll see a few key options here. First up is speed. It's set to 100% by default, which is normal speed. If you want to speed your clip up, you enter a value higher than 100%. Let's try to 100%. See, the clip gets shorter on the timeline, and our action is now twice as fast. To slow it down, you do the opposite. Let's try 50. And just like that, we have slow motion. The clip gets longer to accommodate the new, slower speed. But what about the gap it just created on the timeline? This is where this little checkbox comes in handy. Ripple edit, shift trailing clips. If you check this, Premiere Pro will automatically shuffle everything on your timeline to make room or close gaps. Watch this, I'll slow it down to 50% again, but this time with ripple edit checked. Boom, no gap. Everything just moved over. This is a massive time saver. And one last thing in this box, maintain audio pitch. If your clip has audio, slowing it down makes it sound deep and demonic, and speeding it up makes it sound like a chipmunk. Checking this box uses some digital magic to keep the audio pitch normal, just faster or slower. It's a must-have for clips with dialogue or important music. Okay, so that basic slow motion is fine. Now for a really fun and creative effect, reversing your clip. This is the easiest one of all. I've got this clip of a ball being dropped. Let's make it fly back up into my hand. Just like before, we right-click and go to speed or duration. And all we have to do is check this one little box, reverse speed. Hit OK, and let's see what happens. How cool is that? This is amazing for creative effects, funny moments, or unique intros. You can combine it with speed changes to a fast motion reverse or a slow motion reverse. The possibilities are endless. Okay, it's time for the main event. The technique that all the pros use. Speed ramping. This is how you smoothly transition from one speed to another within the same clip. First, we need to see the time remapping controls. Right-click your clip on the timeline, go down to show clip keyframes, then time remapping, and finally select speed. This white line across our clip represents its speed. Right now, it's a flat line at 100%. By adding keyframes, we can create hills and valleys to change the speed dynamically. I want to slow down the jump, so I'll move my playhead to right before the jump begins. Hold down the control key, that's command on a Mac, and click on the line to add a keyframe. Then I'll move to where the jump ends and add another one. Now for the magic. I'll grab the line between my two keyframes and just drag it down. As I drag it down, the speed decreases. Let's set it to around 40. Now, if I play this back, it will abruptly change from normal to slow and back to normal. It's okay, but it's not a ramp. To make it smooth, click on your keyframe marker. You'll see these two blue halves. Click and drag them apart. Dragging these handles apart creates a ramp. This tells Premiere Pro to gradually ease into and out of the slow motion. The further apart the handles, the longer and smoother the transition. Now let's see the final result. And there you have it. A beautiful, professional speed ramp. You can do the opposite, to drag the line up to create a fast motion section. This technique gives you ultimate control over time in your edits. So now, you know how to speed up and slow down your footage, how to get that silky smooth cinematic slow-mo by interpreting footage, how to create fun reverse effects, and how to build dynamic professional speed ramps. The best way to get comfortable with these tools is to just open up Premiere Pro and play around with them. Grab some footage and experiment. You'll be a time-bending master in no time. If this video helped you out, do me a huge favor and hit that like button. It really helps the channel out. And be sure to subscribe and ring the notification bell so you don't miss any more Premiere Pro tutorials. What a question. Or is there another effect you want to learn? Drop it in the comments below. I read all of them. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.